Welcome back to Bazaar Morning Call. After the US and China have postponed the tariff escalation, looks like everyone is in a good mood this morning. The SGX 50 is up almost 65 odd points, although it has come off from the day's highs, and huge mammoth rallies across markets in Asia. Hong Kong is up almost 800 points. Japan is up more than 300 points. Let's see which way things head. Our research team is here. There's a long list of stocks to track this morning, so let's drill it down to the specifics. Anuj, what are you looking at today?
So one is Aurof Pharma. It's a strong stock in a strong sector, bounced from 20-day moving average, strong pickup in delivery buying, so that's something I'll watch out for. I think IndusInd Bank has given some kind of reversal signal after a 14% rally last month. On Friday, there was a bit of a decline on the stocks, and it was backed by delivery volumes as well. So I don't know. I mean, I'll just want to see how that stock reacts today in trade.
Okay, fair point. I think a stock that's definitely not going to get positive vibes would be Sun Pharma. Our colleague Archana Shukla filed this story over the weekend, listening to this whistleblower complaint in Sun Pharma.
Well, Sun Pharma will certainly be in focus, with reports suggesting that markets regulator SEBI is likely to reopen an insider trading case against Sun Pharma based on a whistleblower report, as well as probe the company on alleged lapses by some of its promoters and other entities in raising FCCBs. The company, its MD and nine other entities in August 2017 had settled an insider trading probe, paying settlement charges of 18 lakh rupees. The whistleblower has reportedly alleged various irregularities, highlighting inadequate disclosures about the company's links with banned traders like Ketan Parekh and Dharmesh Toshi, related transactions and role of promoter Dilip Sanghvi's brother-in-law Sudhir Walia, who's also a director in Sun Pharma. A foreign brokerage report recently had highlighted alleged governance lapses too, and other brokerages had revisited concerns in the rise of related parties and related party transactions. While the stock has already seen some impact of these concerns, these corporate governance concerns, analysts anticipate a further devaluation.
Okay, that's of course Sun Pharma, but auto sector would be in focus today because most numbers look muted, barring a couple of them. But Sonia, go through the details.
Yes, in fact, you know, they were weak in the month of November overall. But the big takeaway is the slowdown we've seen in commercial vehicle sales. So Tata Motors and M&M have both reported a CV sales dip of more than 20%. For Tata Motors alone, the medium and heavy commercial vehicle sales were down 24% on a year-on-year basis. Even Maruti growth has slowed down over there. Sales are down 0.7% in November. Slowdown is visible both in exports and in the mini car segment. The two-wheeler companies have struggled to grow this month. Hero Motor Corp has reported a paltry 0.8% year-on-year growth, while Royal Enfield sales are down 6% year-on-year. Of course, over there, the first 15 days of the month were impacted because of the strike at the Oragadam facility. The tractor growth is the only silver lining this time. Escorts has reported a 56% year-on-year growth this time to 8,005 units. I've taken a three-month average as well, just to compare it with the preceding 3 months. And the last 3 months for Escorts, they've done sales of 31,000 units versus about 19,900 in the preceding 3 months. So that seems to be the only silver lining. I also want to read out one line that Tata Motors has put out in their press release, where they say that the medium and heavy commercial vehicle truck segment has declined by 24%, largely impacted because of a drop in cargo sales as operators have postponed their purchases because of the low consumer sentiment. So sentiment has been hit very hard, because of which freight costs have fallen and operators have postponed their purchases.
Okay, well, I just want to read out some numbers that India Bulls has put out on the exchange. And that's indicating that their net cash position is fairly safe, partly because they have prepaid some of their CPs, and more importantly, because they are expecting EMI payments as well. So the net cash position for December, they are in the cash by about 16,000 crores. For the entire fourth quarter, Jan, Feb, March, they are in the cash by 8,700 crores. And then they go on with Q1, Q2, you know, they're 7,800, 5,000 crores, 6,000 crores, all through the year FY20 as well, and FY21 and 22 as well. They calculate that, you know, their net cash position is fairly liquid. Well, since India Bulls has been at the receiving end of the bears, this hopefully will mollify sentiment.
Okay, well, let's move on and talk about some of the power stocks. Anisha, what are you picking up there?
Well, Sunit, it can be a very positive news for Adani Power, Tata Power and Essa Power because unverified reports suggest that Gujarat government has asked the DISCOM to increase the tariff or amend the PPAs immediately. Now, the operative work there being, word there being operative because remember, this has been a long drawn battle and the Supreme Court had actually referred the matter to CRC and told the Gujarat government to go to CRC. Now, what the report suggests is that the Gujarat government is going to amend the PPA and then approach the CRC simultaneously. In fact, it also hints that for Tata Power, they've already got the consent of the four states involved. So it comes as a very positive news because remember, this can make your tariffs go up for these companies by anywhere between 60 paise to a rupee and that can bring down the under recovery substantially. So definitely a positive for these companies.
Well, absolutely. Yeah, that should be for the banks as well.
Okay, that's something to watch out for. But perhaps the stocks of the morning could well be the aviation stocks because this is one of the largest ever ATF cut that we've seen.
Yes, we have. In fact, it's an 11% month-on-month cut that we've seen in ATF prices. So now, jet fuel prices are at about 68,000 rupees per kiloliter in Delhi. They've been cut by almost 8,200 rupees. Just to give you a trend, you know, in December, it was cut by 11%. The trend will be up for you. The last time it was cut was about in April when it was down 0.3%. So that was the extent of the cut. In October, also, we saw a cut. It was 2.6%. So this 11% cut is really the highest we've seen over the last many, many months. And this is important because as we know, ATF prices account for 40% of the total operating expenses for airlines. Put together in the first half of FY19, the three listed airline companies reported a combined loss of almost 4,000 crore rupees, which means they reported a loss of 20 crores per day in the first half. So a bit of a breather for them.
Oh, absolutely. Well, Sonal, you have some more stocks on your radar.
Yes, good morning, Lata. Well, I'll start with Monte Carlo. The company has announced a buyback amounting to 55 crore rupees. That amounts to 10.5% of the total net worth. Also, the promoters will not be participating in the buyback, so can see some green on the stock today. Some pharma stocks will be also be in focus. We have Cadila, which has received final approval from the US FDA for teriflunomide tablets. Also, one more stock will be in focus is Biocon, because Falfila, that is a biosimilar pegfilgrastim that is jointly developed by the company and Mylan, has received an approval from the European Commission. So that is some positive news coming in for the company. Moil will also be in focus because the company has raised discounts on certain grades of fines from 15% to 15% from 10%. So definitely some price cuts we'll be seeing. So negative news for the stock coming in.
Okay, thanks a lot for that. So here's a quick recap then of our top stocks to watch. Stocks with positive news flow this morning include names like Aurobindo Pharma, Indiabulls Housing Finance, Adani Power, Tata Power, Jet Airways, Interglobe Aviation, SpiceJet, Cadila, Biocon and Monte Carlo. While stocks with negative news flow are IndusInd Bank, Sun Pharma, Tata Motors, M&M, Aisha Motors, Maruti and MOIL. We'll discuss these stocks with our technical gurus on the other side as well. Do stay with us. Plenty of technical tips coming up with Ashwini Gujral, Sudarshan Sukhani and Mitesh Thakkar.